All right, ladies and gentlemen, y'all already know what time it is. If you like the video, subscribe for more daily 2K content, and let's get right into the news. Oh, yeah, before we do that, Gym Stars! What's going on, everybody? It's your boy, Jay-Eazy, a.k.a. Fresh from the Barbershop, BKA the People's Champ, coming to you live with another video. Look, it's all good this morning, ladies and gentlemen. I know I've been on 2K's head all week. I'm not gonna lie to you, but my channel is never always negative. I give credit where credit is due, and when there's time to hold someone's feet to the fire, that's what I do. So, we're gonna get the negative out of the way real quick. Demigod Glitch, still in the game, still Radio Silence from 2K. It is what it is. At this point, somebody actually said that that's been in the game since, NBA 2K16, the little edit roster glitch. It's been in that since 2K16, so maybe they don't know how to fix it, and thus, it is what it is. Me and Madman Grindhard and possibly Brutal Sim, we're going to be doing a podcast tonight. Me, Brutal Sim, and, well, whatever. Whoever's available, we're going to do one. We're going to talk about this. Because me and Madman were saying it's crazy because you ever notice when you are on a streak and then somebody will come, they'll play you one game, and then they be out? That's how that may be what it is, that they've been doing this since 2K16, steroiding their player up, coming out there, beat you that one game, and then they out. They'll never give you a rematch. Maybe that's what it is. But anyway, still in the game, still Radio Silence. They haven't said anything, but since we've heard that it's been in the game since NBA 2K16, I don't know if they know how to fix it. It is what it is. On to the good news, man. Like I said, we have so much good news this morning. The Puma Mania event is working, and it is freaking awesome. Like, I'm not gonna lie to y'all. I don't care about the event itself, but I do care about the double rep. Yo, my boy Paul, I showed him how to spin. I got the spin the wheel method. We'll be putting that out tonight. If you want to spin the wheel method this evening, let me know. I gave him the spin the wheel method. I'm gonna have him to send me his screenshot too, but while we were doing it, I got 4 hours worth of Gatorade. The last time I told y'all I got 4 hours worth of boost. Paul got 2 hours worth of double rep. Went out there and played a couple of games. Boom, he got his superstar or whatever. And it was great, man. Like the event is awesome. The park is not laggy. It's nice and smooth. You can play on every court, which leads me to believe that the park that they have, like the little park overlay with the witch and everything that everybody was saying, the witch flying overhead and you know, the cornfield at the end and all that extra stuff. Hey, 2K, just reset the park. Matter of fact, leave it like it is in Puma Mania right now, because right now, park is so lit, like there's no lag. There's no delay when you're trying to move your player. There's no none of that. It ain't lagging. Nobody's lagging out. Nobody's doing anything. So us holding their feet to the fire on yesterday and saying, bro, we can't take this. This is not acceptable. It worked. We came through. And you know what I'm saying? Like just making your opinion heard. This is not complaining. You have to make your voice be heard. Because if you don't make your voice be heard when things go wrong, they will... if you do the same thing that you're doing, you'll get the same thing that you've been getting. Or as my mama used to say, you know, people always think the definition of insanity is doing the same thing, expecting a different result. But it's doing the same thing the same way and expecting a different result. Like going to work to a dead end job and thinking you're going to get rich. Going to work can get you rich. You just can't go to the dead end job. You see what I'm saying? You might have to work for yourself or something like that. But working can get you there. It's just how you do it. So that's the definition of insanity. Definition of insanity, doing the same thing the same way. We're making the, so just taking it from 2K. We're saying, okay, 2K, we're gonna turn around and take it. What position you want us in this time? Nah, we're not doing that anymore. This show right here, 2K Morning, or whatever y'all want to call it, we, the Gym Stars, we gotta mobilize, just like Twante always says. We gotta let them know, bro, these are the things that we want. Let's see if we can keep it. Well, we only got 1 week of Halloween left anyway, so hopefully they'll change it to something where park is actually playable, or just leave it like it is. Reset the park to how it was. However it is, I don't understand why Puma Mania is so smooth, but the original park that they had wasn't as smooth. And the pumpkin park is not as smooth, but Puma Mania is so smooth, it's not even funny. Now, like I said, all you got to do, go out there, play. We played more games. We had some competitive games. Everything was great. So, kudos to 2K. Hey, Shout out to them. And like I said, y'all know I'm the Puma head, the resident Puma mascot. I got these. And I don't know what my ones are that look like the Jordans or whatever, man. Like somebody said in the comments talking about you got some Pumas that look like Jordans. Bro, I don't care what they look like. I buy the shoe. I like how it looks. I'm a grown man. I buy what I want. That's one of the benefits of being grown. You can do exactly what you want and nobody can say anything about it of any relevance. So, you know, it is what it is. Like I said, the event's working. We're back in business. The park is awesome. It's lit. It's going to be lit all weekend. I will be getting my quadruple rep. And, we back in it, chat. But, anyway, another thing that's good this weekend. We had an update required at like 3 a.m. yesterday. I don't know what was in that update required. But boy, it was like some steroids was in that update required. Because me and Paul was like, bro, the game is fun, it's smooth, but it's a little bit slower. We couldn't make our rotations. We couldn't do exactly what we wanted to. It's like Paul was moving so hella slow because he got a 7-3 center. And we were talking about how they pretty much have killed the 7-3 centers, right? So, like, if you got a 7-3 center, let me know if they got you so slow that you can't do anything. Like, Paul would try to pivot. He couldn't even pivot, right? So, update required came through. After that update required, I don't know if they changed the game speed. I don't know if they changed the lateral quickness. I don't know what they changed, but I know I was locking motherfuckers up last night after they changed their update required. My dude was sliding all over the place at a real speed because I got like 91 speed. I'm sliding all over the place. I'm D'ing people up. Nobody can get by me. Nobody can do nothing. Like, the game right now feels like the game should have felt on launch, on release. Right now, the game feels better than it has ever felt. And this ain't no cap. Y'all let me know. Maybe I'm capping. Y'all let me know. But let me know if this morning, if you played this morning after the update required, does the game not feel smoother, a lot faster, a lot more fluid? Like, it really feels like I felt like the game should have felt day one. Now, if we're going to get this good gameplay for the rest of the year, I'll deal with whatever we had to go through to get here. Hey, the end justifies the means sometimes. I don't want to do this every year, 2K. But sometimes the ends justify the means. This game is super fun to me. I don't know, like, some people probably think I'm complaining all the time. You don't complain about things you don't care about. You've not seen me complain about a Call of Duty in years because I don't care about that game. I love Call of Duty, but they got me to the point where I just don't care about the game anymore. So when there's something that I love, I want it to be the best that it can be. That's why I complain about my child when he goes to school. And I make sure that my child is good, y'all children or y'all, but it's not even on my little mind. Because you complain about or you care the most about the things that you actually care about. Not care about my subs and stuff, but y'all get what I'm trying to say. You don't care about the next person's child as far as what the grades look like, what this is going on. That's why your mama be on your behind and she ain't on your little friend behind. She don't care about them, she care about you. So that's why, if you care about something, you're the hardest on it. If you don't care about something, it's not something that's to be worried about. You're not on it that bad. I love 2K. I think that this game can be great. I see the potential in this game. I didn't see the potential in 19. I saw the potential in 19 in the beginning. It was there. Could have been the best 2K ever. And I told Swante in a tweet, in a private message, I said, this could be the best 2K ever, but it could simultaneously be the worst 2K ever if they make the wrong moves. They made the wrong moves. They made it the worst 2K ever. To me, in my opinion. That's why I didn't play it, I didn't upload it, and I didn't really do anything until the end of the game when I made a playmaker and I had to do something to make the game fun for me. Right now, this game is super fun to me. I don't understand what's not to be fun. It's a big skill gap at times. Some people have found ways to cheese the game, to standing behind the back and then throwing you in the screens, which they need to fix, by the way. The screens definitely need to be addressed. The grabbing picks, the ones where, again, the screen is right here. I'm going this way, but the screen is right here, and he still grabs me and pulls me and makes me. They got to fix that, but I ain't worried about that. Just leave the game how it is right now. Don't touch a thing, because Park is dope. It's no lag. Everything is good. Game speed is awesome. All of that good stuff. Anyway, man, I'm not going to harp on about that. We got a video from NBA 2K Lab talking about, this is more good news, talking about quick first step. Cap, number 9. Look, all right, look, check it out. They said, quick first step, in normal situations, this is escape behind the back right here. they're saying that we don't care about the people with 50 ball speed. This is for somebody with 90 ball speed right here, right? They said that in most moves, it's going to be a 35 to 37% increase. Link to the videos down in the description. For most moves, 35 to 37% increase. But from a straight standstill, for us corner guys, you know, people that are support players that go stand in the corner and then we get the ball and we do something. If you got it on Hall of Fame, 55% increase in your first step. If you got 50 ball speed, it's 52%. It's still good for you. And if you got it on gold, like most of us probably have it on, it's a 45% increase, 43% if you got 50 ball speed. I think it's dope. I've told y'all since the beginning, this is one of the best badges in the game. I created my build so that I could get quick first step. I created it just like that because I knew how essential it was going to be for me. Like, it really felt like they made NBA 2K 20 for me. And a lot of people were saying, you know, you get like in the comments yesterday, well, I was trying to tell y'all, look, I have a 3-and-D guard, and with a 3-and-D guard, you cannot get floor general unless you're a point guard. The 3-and-D 2 can't get it. And everybody was like, well, I have a shooting guard and I got it. You probably are playmaker primary, or you have very high playmaking. My build doesn't have high playmaking. I only got 9 playmaking badges. So for me to get floor general, I had to make a point guard. I couldn't make another build. So I just wanted to clear that up because a lot of people felt like it was necessary to say it. But I'm like, bro, you don't have a 3-and-D guard. How would you know? They're like, I got a 2-way sharp facilitator. Yeah, you playmaking primary, or you got very high playmaking. I don't have high playmaking. So the only way that I could get floor general and Dimer together was for me to make a point guard. It is what it is, though. I just wanted to clear that up right there. Like I said, if you got a 3-and-D guard, y'all let me know down in the comments. Also, like I said, the 2K Lab video, dope. Go check that out. And last but not least, man, we got a message from the guy. The guy of the last 2 days, man. We got a message from your boy Duke Dennis, man. So let's see what he had to say. And I want to see if you guys agree with this right here. Let's go.
I wanted to ask y'all a little question.
Go ahead and ask it, Duke.
Do y'all think 2K YouTubers are the reason that 2K is trash?
I don't think it's trash, but
that's true, but I just seen a few people saying it on Twitter, and I wanted to ask y'all. So yeah, do y'all think 2K YouTubers are the problem? Or do y'all think that it's the company themselves? You know what I'm saying? Elaborate. I just want to hear y'all thoughts. Because... You don't see the Fortnite community saying that all the Twitch streamers and all the YouTubers and Ninja, you don't hear them saying that they the reason why the game.
I'm gonna stop you right there, Duke. Yes, you do. With Fortnite, you hear them say that all the time, especially Ninja. And like when the game first came out, well, we'll let him finish and then we'll.
You know what I'm saying? Like, what can they do, to be honest? Like YouTubers have no say in what go on in the game whatsoever. Like, and I used to think the same way until I became one, and I'm trying to voice my opinions and they ain't being heard, just like y'all's not being heard. What I'm saying is, you don't hear, you know what I'm saying? I just wanna hear y'all thoughts. Let me know.
Back to camera. Cap, can we get the camera back? All right, look, I understand what Duke is trying to say, and I think it's a good-hearted way for him to try to, you know, to try to see what the community thinks, gauge the community. But Duke, they're not listening to you. they are listening to YouTubers. They are in people's streams. They're in certain people's streams all the time, and they are listening to them. And they are definitely, most definitely, 100%, I can confirm, making changes to the game based upon what some YouTubers and Twitch streamers say. So it may not be as much Twitch as much YouTubers as it is Twitch streamers. They're an annoying stream all the time. They take his suggestions all the time. They're in Poor Boy Sin stream all the time. They take his suggestions all the time. If you don't believe it, go back and look at Poor Boy Sin's tweet. He's to thank, because I'm glad that they did it. And this is one of those where our what would you say? Our our visions coincided, or our wants coincided, where the step back at the beginning of the year was on the left stick, and now they changed it back to the right stick, so it's right stick and it's right trigger, right stick down. It used to be right trigger, left stick down. So YouTubers and Twitch streamers more probably than YouTubers, because Twitch streamers are actually playing the game. They absolutely take their opinion and they change the game in a lot of ways in their likeness. The only thing that I don't like is, like, that was a community thing that Poor Boy Sin was talking about. The only thing I don't like is when people want things to change for their own selfish interests, and then they push those things to the forefront. Like when people wanted fades to go in and stuff like that. Fades had no business going in at the rate that they were from three. It was crazy. Fades themselves had no business going in at the rate they were going in, because people couldn't shoot them. And then now that they've nerfed them, you only have a few people that can shoot them. So that shows that that they needed to be changed. Anytime there's something in the game to make somebody that's mediocre, make them be god tier, it has to be nerfed. That's just all to it. So, absolutely, people are the YouTubers. It's not just YouTubers in general. It's the ones that they listen to. If they would listen to me on a lot of these things that I already know, and then they ultimately end up changing for the better, or just let us test the game out for like 2 weeks or something, and then we could try to abuse it. We would have known that you needed to fix fades from the jump. Like stuff like that, but you know, it is what it is. So YouTubers absolutely have an influence on the game, and it's not always for the better. If you listen to somebody like, if you listen to certain people that actually play the game a lot, and actually try to play straight up game, listen to people like Coyote, myself, Man Grindhard, we just want a game that's straight up and down the middle. We don't care about us having an advantage. Make the game, and most of the time, what do you hear us say? Leave it like it is, especially right now how it is, 2K, leave it like it is. When shooting came out, people were like, man, shooting is too hard. We're like, leave it like it is. They let them adjust. When people were smoking layups left and right, we gotta change it. And then now it's to a point where you can't miss a layup. These things are because people cried about it, and the right people cried about it, and then they changed it and made the game in their likeness. But like I said, especially, and then also with Fortnite, they never said Ninja did anything.
You never heard of Double Pump, did you? Well, I'm going to give you a quick schooling here. In the beginning of Fortnite, there was something called Double Pump. My boy Daquan, he actually made it famous, and it was one of the best strategies to use, especially against noobs, because you could bow. You could just bop, bop, and you could just get somebody out of there before the building epidemic happened. Guess who got that up out of here? They were in Ninja Stream every day. He said it's not fair or balanced. And he was right. Ain't no doubt about it. He was right. It was not fair or balanced, but it was fun to a lot of people. I thought it was trash. I'm glad they took it out of the game, because it made you have to have more skill. But guess what? I used it until they took it out, because you're not going to use something against me, and then I'm not going to hit you back. It's just like people buying steroids from the boost lady. But anyway, so that's just one of many things that they changed in the game to suit Ninja. Since that's the person that you wanted to use. But yes, he absolutely had an influence on the game, and people say it all the time, Ninja is ruining Fortnite, or he's killing Fortnite. You may just not be in the right Reddit forums or the right tweets, but yes, they say that all the time. Y'all let me know if y'all know Double Pump. Give me a Double Pump down in the comments. If that Adina Howard. Give me that Adina Howard down there. Pump, pump. All through the night to the early morning. Anyway, man, I got to get up out of here, man. I done had way too much fun this morning. Right now, the game, just like my guy Longhorn said yesterday, NBA 2K is in a great place right now. I'm enjoying the game. The event is working. And we back at it like a snack addict, boy. And like I said, I'm enjoying 2K. I'm going to be playing it all year. We're going to be getting at least 2 videos a day. So y'all get ready for that. I'll be on today. I'm about to go back and get back to Puma Mania. I'm probably streaming right now. So hit the stream up. Link is down in the description. Twitch.tv/JEasy. Hey, if you like this shirt, if you made it this far, leave your size down in the comments. I'm gonna pick somebody, and we're gonna give away one of the shirts. We're gonna give away either the Beast Mode Activated, Dog Work Don't Lie, Gym Star shirts. I also got one. What do y'all think? Is this too much? It's gonna say, you know how the MAGA shirts are, Make America Great Again. It's gonna say Make Abs Great Again, and then it's gonna have like
like the outline of your abs right here. So it's gonna say make abs great again, and then it's gonna have the outline of your abs right there. Y'all let me know if this is that too much or whatever, man. Anyway, I gotta get up out of here. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Leave a like if you like the video, subscribe if you're new, and until next time, it's your boy Jay Easy, aka Fresh from the Barbershop, BK the People's Champ. Hello. Hey, also leave down in the comments if it's playing better for you. If it's not, let me know if you're still having issues. How's the game playing for you? Are you enjoying it? Whether you're enjoying it or not, let your boy know. And I'm going to catch y'all next time. Godspeed.